Are we there?
Cryosleep procedure completed successfully. Initializing hydrothermal control procedure. Pressure check. Normal. Oxygen saturation check. Normal. Subject is free to disengage cryopod lock. Mild signs of confusion detected. These are normal in around 22% of deep cryosleep procedures. Full cognitive capacity should be restored in a few hours. In order to ease the process of prolonged cryosleep rehabilitation, a detailed mission overview and specific exoplanet survival guide can be performed. Welcome to the EO Solar System. Location, Triptych 1, Orion Arm. We are currently approaching the third terrestrial planet in this solar system, planet EO3, at landing speed. Estimated landing time, 3 hours, 45 minutes. From our preliminary analysis, planet EO3 does appear to be indeed a mostly glacier planet. However, a few hotspots on the planet's surface have been detected. These appear to be geothermal in nature, and warm liquid appears to be present in those sectors. We were also able to detect the Genesis ship in the Alpha sector of EO3, and as such, landing in that sector is advised. Before we proceed to the landing procedure, a quick exoplanet survival guide will be useful. Since this appears to be mostly an aquatic planet, surviving in open water will be our main focus. Your data pad has been calibrated to monitor your overall health, hunger, and thirst levels, as well as your oxygen levels, which will be displayed on your HUD starting now. Oxygen and depth levels will be visible once submerged. This data pad will also be able to monitor other metrics, such as your overall mental health and body temperature, as survival on an alien planet can sometimes take a toll on one's body. You can now press Tab on your data pad. On the left-hand side, you can see 5 buttons that will direct you to the different systems controlled by the data pad. System 1 is your equipment, inventory, and crafting system. System 2 contains a map of the sector and your location, as well as the location of other components on it. It also contains data regarding all the zones and other important actors to be encountered on the expedition. System 3 contains data regarding your mission and will also store any additional data logs recovered. It also offers an overview of blueprint progression in case new tools or equipment might need crafting, which is not in the USF data bank. System 4 contains all data and controls related to me, Eve, your personal assistant on this mission. I have 3 main modes you can put me in, which, if used correctly, could greatly increase your survival chances and thus, mission success. Finally, System 5 is grayed out as you need access to a builder-type tool. This system will allow you to construct your own outpost if needed. While planet EO3, especially Sector Alpha, appears to be in the upper tier of hospitability to life, caution is still greatly advised. 3 possible landing locations have been detected in Sector Alpha. Please proceed to the control terminal and select a landing location. appears to be Outpost Alpha. Structural analysis indicates the outpost was abandoned years ago. Precious materials and data could, however, still be present.
Thank you. Thank you.
defense mode activated. Eve analysis mode activated. Thank you.
oxygen levels low.
I gotta say, Eve, I feel a strange kind of optimism being in this place. Like, maybe not everything is lost after all. In millions of years, humanity might not be around anymore, but life will still be present in the universe, spreading its seeds as it always has. I find that beautiful.
Life is inscribed into the existence of the universe itself. It may look fragile on the surface, and at the individual level, but in time, it has the power to shape reality itself. It always had this power.
Thank you. Thank you.